Hello everyone, I'm Alex, I'm a geology student at the University of Edinburgh, and welcome to my first video! So ever since I was young, I've been super interested in paleontology. Just gonna take my glasses off, too much shine. And I really wanted to bring more attention to Scottish paleontology and geology, because whenever I look online, it's all kind of about places like America or China or Canada. And whilst obviously they have really great fossils and they have great geology, so does Scotland, and I think it's really important to remember that. So today I'm here to tell you all about my top 5 favourite paleontological finds and discoveries that have happened in Scotland. So I hope you enjoy! So anyway, my number 5 on my list of my top 5 favourite paleontology discoveries in Scotland is the Rhynie Chert. The Rhynie Chert has extraordinary preservation of the fossils. It's from the early Devonian, 410 million years old to be precise, which is obviously extremely old. It has an exceptional state of ultra-structural preservation with individual cell walls actually visible, which is crazy. So the location of this is near the village of Rhynie in Aberdeenshire. Here is the map for you. So this was formed when silica-rich volcanic water from a volcanic spring rose rapidly and pretty much petrified the terrestrial ecosystem. So the Rhynie Chert was one of the first examples of an early terrestrial ecosystem. It was of course formed in the hot spring, but it featured lots of plants, no flowers of course, because flowers had not yet evolved. Most of the plants were just kind of strange twig-like things. So of course, because it's so old, one of the oldest fossil records in the world, some of the oldest fossils in the world, you know, that is why I wanted to put it as my number 5. My number 4 on the list is Arthropleura, which is a giant millipede. You can actually find the trace fossils or the trackways from this on the Isle of Arran on the west coast. You might have heard of this if you watch Walking with Monsters or Prehistoric Park. You can find Arthropleura in Scotland and North America, as it used to be joined, although obviously not any longer. These are about 345 to 295 million years old, and they can be anything from 0.3 to 2.5 meters long, which of course is huge. One of the, I think, are the largest invertebrate ever to live. The reason they got so big was because of a lack of terrestrial predators as well as more heavily oxygenated atmosphere. The body of Arthropleura is made up of 30 jointed segments, which is covered by 2 side plates and a centre plate. These actually became extinct at the end of the Carboniferous, when the lush, moist rainforest environment started to dry out to what became massive deserts in the Permian. Halfway through, so my number three on my list are the early tetrapods in Scotland. There used to be this thing called Romer's Gap, which is kind of like a gap in the fossil record. They didn't know, because before Romer's Gap, everything seemed to be in the sea. There was nothing on land, and then all of a sudden, after Romer's Gap, there was things on land, but there was nothing really bridging them. So this gap ran from about 360 to 340 million years ago. There was just a lack of fossils, and a lack of understanding about how these tetrapods got on land. To fill this gap, the Tweed Project was set up, and this was set up to find things to put in the gap, essentially. So the Tweed Project, along with Scotland's best fossil hunter, Stan Wood, who you may know from if you've ever been to Edinburgh and seen Mr. Wood's fossil shop, which is one of my favourite shops ever. That is a shop in memory of him. So this group of people, Tweed Project, went out to try and find some fossils to fill in Romer's Gap. So they found a number of species in Scotland. I think there was in total 5 locations where they were able to find it, but I'm just going to talk about a couple of them because I don't want to throw all this information at you. And yeah, so one of them, one that's nearest to me, is probably one that was found in West Lothian, and it was called West Lothiana Lizzie. This was in 1984. Age of this early Theropod is 345 million years old. It was also in 1917, Pedarpes, which was found in Dumbarton. It was originally thought to be a fish until the early 2000s, and they took a look at it again, and it turned out to be another early tetrapod in the gap. Conveniently enough, it was more found at O'Willy's Hole in the Borders, and also Balnerpeton. So yeah, I'm gonna link the proper articles about these below, because I don't want this video to be half an hour long and you all to get bored. So link in below if you want to learn more about them. Well, I'm going to talk about what a tetrapod is, because I think I'm being confusing. So these are kind of like, so tetrapods, weird tetrapods. Tetrapods are anything with four limbs, basically, or stemming off something that had four limbs. Next on my list is Elgin reptiles, and in particular saltopods. The Elgin reptiles were of course discovered in Elgin in Murray, and the most famous of this probably being saltopus, because it was an early dinosaur morph. A dinosaur morph being sort of like a type of archosaur, but before dinosaurs. So it wasn't quite yet a dinosaur, but it's in the same family tree as dinosaurs and crocodiles and birds. So it's the start of the dinosaur stem of the family tree. So it was preserved in sandstone natural casts. I always remember one of the things that always sticks in my head from first year of uni is that the National Museum of Scotland is actually made out of the Elgin sandstone that the dinosaurs were in, so who knows, maybe there's some dinosaur morphs hanging about in the museum walls. So back to saltopus. Saltopus was about the size of a cat, so it's like about 80 to 100 centimeters long, most of the length being the actual tail itself. It had hollow bones, kind of like a dinosaur, well, the same as a dinosaur, and it had five-fingered hands, which was quite strange looking because you never really expect a dinosaur looking animal to have five fingers. Did I say five hands? I meant five fingers. This was discovered in the Lossiemouth quarries, and it's about 221 to 210 million years old. So my number one is, of course, you all guessed it, the Skye dinosaurs. So the Isle of Skye is known as Scotland's dinosaur isle. Very popular with tourists, so I actually took a visit to it. I'm probably going to be doing another video just dedicated to Skye and all the cool discoveries, as well as my trip to it. But for now, I'd like to tell you just a couple of things that I think is cool. So there's lots of dinosaur footprints. Honestly, the more I read about it, the more I realised there's just so much. It deserves its own video. Got, I think, theropod tracks at Ancoran on Staffin Beach, which is what I actually went to see. It was really cool. There's sauropod trackways at Berlewis Point, as well as I've seen in the news recently there's actually new stegosaur tracks, which is really exciting because I don't think there's been a stegosaur in Scotland before, or we haven't discovered one before. So in addition to all the trace fossils or trackways, there is also actual genuine fossils. So they found a limb bone of a cetiosaur, which is a type of sauropod, also another limb bone of a theropod. But yeah, there's so many discoveries on Skye. I know a lot of the researchers at Edinburgh University, which is where I go, are still working on stuff there. The first discovery in Skye was in 1982, and then in the early 1990s it just sort of kicked off. There's been so many discoveries since then, and it just keeps going and going. And now Skye is a very popular place to go if you're looking for dinosaur bones. And also in Skye, like, we also seen a lot of like little fossils, we've seen some trace fossils, some shelly fossils. It's a really great time, so I would 10 out of 10 recommend. So that's it for my whistle stop tour of my top 5 favourite fossil and paleontological discoveries in Scotland. I'm going to include some links below if you want to read more about it. This is just a quick overview. I know it's not very in depth, but I wanted to just make sure I covered as much as I could. This is my first video. I'm really looking to do a few more. I just think it's fun, something nice to do. I hope you all like my dinosaur earrings. So please like, subscribe, tell me what you thought in the comments. I'm no professional, so if I got stuff wrong, please do not be afraid to call me out. I'm just a student and interested in this stuff. If you are going to Edinburgh University, may I recommend Palaeontology Society? I am the current president. We were established in early this year, actually. It seems so long ago. We established the society kind of in late 2019, early 2020, and we're really looking to kick things off this year. We've got so much planned. So please, if you are at the university, please come and join us. We're all just undergrad students, just interested in it, so there's no need to be an expert or anything. And I will hopefully see you all next time. Bye!